This is a Morse Code Simulator I created using Nintendo Labo. A quick push will output a dot, and a quick hold would output a dash. You have 1.5 seconds to type your code, and the display will show the assigned letter. Then everything disappears after 0.5 seconds. This program mainly consists of 3 steps. The first step is to make one bond have 2 different outputs depending on the value. In this case, we want 1 little push to come out as a dot and 1 little hold from the same bond to come out as a dash. We can achieve this by setting a different input target for dot and dash. What range should it be? Let's find out what a typical push will turn out in counter node. Looks like it's about 2 to 3 and could be up to 6. Let's set the dot input target to 1 to 10 so it can accommodate some minor irregulars. Then all the rest can go to the dash input target. In other words, any inputs less than 10 will turn out dot, and greater than 10 will turn out dash. Success! Step 2. Make it go on to the next row after each input. We can achieve this by assigning each row with a counter trigger node and set the range corresponding to the assigned row. Use end node to merge it with the existing logic, and then it would look something like this. Success! Step 3. Take the actual Morse code pattern as a trigger to light up the letter in the display. The bullseye node won't work here because the dash would trigger the dot. The counter hold node, however, not only has light up info, it also has location info from step 2. But here's the problem. Morse code for letter A and E share the same pattern at the same row, therefore triggering both letters at the same time in the display. Each trigger has to be unique and different for this logic to work. We can solve this by adding what did not get used in the logic as well. We can either connect the counter hold node for each dot and dash not being used in the not node, or connect the counter trigger node from step 2 instead as it contains both dot and dash and save some lines. Success! I hope my findings in this video will be helpful to your own Labo project. Happy coding!